Hello, space fans, and welcome to Your Sky Tonight. My name is Tony Darnell from deepastronomy.space. Tonight, we're going to take a look at the Orionid Meteor Shower. Meteor showers are a great opportunity and offer a great excuse to go outside and look up. The Orionid Meteor Shower starts in the early fall of each year and, as with all meteor showers, occur as a result of the Earth as it travels on its orbit around the Sun, passing through a debris field left behind by other denizens of the solar system, comets, asteroid collisions from the early solar system, and anything that can cause small clumps of dust and rocks to form. In the case of the Orionid Meteor Shower, we are looking at small particles and rocks that were left behind by the famous Halley's Comet as it passed by the Earth in 1986. Halley's Comet travels around the Sun once every 75 years or so. It is a dazzling comet that can be seen with the naked eye. And, well, unless you're somewhat young as you watch this episode, you won't get to see it again in your lifetime, as it's next expected to fly by in 2061, some 44 years from now. Now, I know for sure I won't be around unless I can somehow manage to live until I'm 99 years old. The Orionid Meteor Shower gets its name from the constellation that most of the meteors appear to come from in the sky, in this case, the famous constellation of Orion. Orion doesn't rise until about 11 p.m. Eastern Time this time of year, so you may want to go and take a look just before heading off to bed. As I said, viewing a meteor shower only requires that you go outside and look up. You don't need any equipment. Well, except maybe a lounge chair, a blanket, and a flask of hot chocolate. If you go out after Orion rises, feel free to stay up as late as you want. You'll be treated to a light show well into the morning hours. The best area to look will be due east around midnight Eastern Time. Find the belt of Orion and look for the bright red star Betelgeuse. That area of sky is where you'll see the meteors entering the Earth's atmosphere at the rate of about 10 to 15 per hour. The peak of the Orionid Meteor Shower this year, which is the time when the most meteors per hour can be seen, and it represents the day that the Earth goes through the densest part of the debris cloud, will occur this weekend, lasting from October 20th through the 23rd. So, if you miss it or if it's cloudy one night, you'll still be able to see lots of meteors coming from this area of the sky any day this weekend, and even well into November. And after about November 7th, they will diminish greatly as the Earth has passed through Halley's Trail. Well, that's it for tonight, space fans. I hope you can take some time to go outside over the next few days or the week ahead and enjoy the amazing spectacle of the Orionid Meteor Shower. Thank you for watching, and as always, keep looking up. Deep Astronomy is sponsored by The Great Courses Plus, a subscription on-demand video learning service where space fans can enjoy lectures in astronomy from top professors from around the world. I particularly recommend Exoplanets, What Astronomers Know by Dr. Joshua Wynn. Go to thegreatcoursesplus.com/deepastronomy to get a free one-month trial to check out all the great stuff they have. And you can support Deep Astronomy by getting a subscription. I think space fans everywhere will get a lot out of their courses.